Characteristic of transitional people. We as human beings living in Earth and on Earth in transition. Earth is not our place, not our permanent place. This is our actually how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us. Okay? The only constant in life is change. These are basic facts. We look at the mirrors every 5-10 years and look at our faces. One that actually we are changing from childhood to adulthood to all these sort of things. So if we understand all these facts, we have to find that we are living in a constant change. Why I'm talking about this today is because you have to be prepared all the time for the change. If we are not going to prepare ourselves for the change, we'll be left behind. And the boat will be sailed by somebody else. I've seen the Arab Spring, which happened a few years back. All the positives and negatives are not talking about the politics of it, but we are talking about the preparedness of the community for the change and the ability of the community and the society to respond to any change in the society. Some of these characteristics are, which I mentioned, because I want you to ask questions more than I gave a talk. I thought there was 15 or 16 characters in front of us, which you have to be ready for all of them. First one is the constant preparedness, الاستعداد التام لحالة التغير. You have to be ready at any time, at any cost, to plan ourselves for the next step. We pass the primary education, we go to the secondary, we go to the university, then we do PhD, then we get married, then we get the children and so on. So the constant preparedness in our life. There is no list. This is the point number one. Point number two is to be open to other people, not to exclude ourselves from society, not to live in ghettos. But if we live in ghettos, we'll never understand what's happening in the surrounding, whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims. The third point is to build partnership with other community members and network with them, to learn from them and to educate them of our experience. Cannot do it alone. There's no one political party, there's no one jama'ah can do anything alone in any country nowadays. You have to partner with others that you agree with their ideology, and some of them you might not agree with their ideology. Point number four, quite often talk about one thing without agreeing on the definition. If democracy for you is not the same for me. If we are in a meeting and we define talk about freedom, democracy, liberty, all this kind of terminology, you have to agree on the definition of the terminology before we go to the meeting. Principles of dialogue. Dialogue is between two people, two groups, or more. It's not a monologue. Even in our houses, it becomes a monologue between the father and the children, the mother and the children. It's not a dialogue. Even here, in the mosques, in the meetings, the chairman is making the talk. So this kind of our meetings about dialogue is to listen till you understand what other people are talking about. Then you can respond. But often we're not very good in dialogue, or actually make it a monologue type.